the fact that that it was even close was very tragic to me.
A cloud of anxiety and uncertainty hovered above hundreds of people who gathered outside of Oakland City Hall today. Racial justice advocates, including those who took part in this past summer's Black Lives Matter demonstrations, joined climate change organizers like the 1,000 Grandmothers for Future Generations to chant the same three words, count every vote.
And unfortunately, we have a president who has, before even all of the votes were counted, and when in fact he was losing, said, I actually won.
It's just depressing, honestly. I have rarely been this scared, and I'm an old lady.
Count, count, count every vote.
Nancy Feinstein, no relation to Senator Dianne Feinstein, wants to leave a healthy planet for her two grandkids. She says four more years of President Trump means four more years of trashing our environment.
It's our generation that's left young people with the mess that we have.
It was a sleepless night for Joe Lamb of Berkeley, who thought the presidential race wouldn't be this close.
I woke up this morning really sad.
With the Trump campaign laying the groundwork for contesting the outcome in undecided battleground states, demonstrators in Oakland say, let democracy play its course, no matter how long it might take.
We need to ensure that every single vote is counted.
What I felt in my gut was that this country is in big trouble.
And Oakland police have upped their staffing this week to facilitate peaceful gatherings just like this one. They say they're also prepared if there's any potential civil unrest happening either tonight or later this week. That's the latest here in Oakland. I'm Melissa Colorado, NBC Bay Area News.